The John LeBanks Show has been known to make people laugh, sing, think, scream, throw things in rage, and generally lose their minds. Listener discretion is advised. So thank you for joining me. No singing today. Maybe a little more serious. I don't know. I'm kind of tired this morning. Been a long weekend. Got a lot accomplished because we're coming up against the end of the month, and we try to put out as much as we can each month to give you content. And because we're running up against it, we had a few things that were a little bit behind, so we're catching up on those. Now we've got some news stories to talk about. We'll also go over the sludge report. Maybe talk about, I don't know, whatever comes to mind. But I wanted to begin with this CNN. You know who they are. They're the leaders of the malpractice media. We call them the Communist News Network, Clinton News Network. Many of us give them different names. But they're always ahead of the game when it comes to secret military classified information. Or remember way back when nobody at all could find Osama bin Laden, and lo and behold, there out of nowhere was CNN to get an interview with the guy. And they said within some months that there was going to be an attack on the U.S. And what happened after that? Well, we all know what happened after that. So, apparently they got wind of some kind of secret classified military war games of sorts. Some kind of operation to practice against the old boogie-woogie over there, 31. Just in case something were to come up with 31. Our buddies over there, they always seem to be ahead of the game when it's breaking information like that. They have sources, so to speak. What this is doing, ladies and gentlemen, is just preparing you. Because if it was classified, somebody would be getting in a lot of trouble for making this public knowledge. Because the classified information doesn't just get released without some sort of leak, which, of course, CNN has their, you know how they do, sources, right? They have all their sources. Here's a little bit of the article, just so you understand what's going on. The enemies will have fictional names, but when hundreds of U.S. military personnel around the globe log on to their computers later this summer for a highly classified war game, it will be clear what a major focus of the scenario will be. How the U.S. should respond to aggressive action and unexpected moves by 31 and Vladimir Putin. Several defense officials tell CNN that the war game is a top priority for the chairman of Joint Chiefs of Staff, who will lead the exercise. Okay, so, and sorry I didn't put my glasses on, I probably should when I'm reading, but you know, we don't like doing that. So several defense officials are leaking this information. If it's classified, remember, ladies and gentlemen, Where's the grand juries on this? Because we know there's some grand juries going on in Georgia, or possible grand juries going on in Georgia over the orange man and his claims over the Operation Ballot Box, which he could have done something about if he was preemptive. Why aren't these officials being sought out by the Pentagon and by the president? Joe Petto, what's up, man? You got people leaking classified information to the malpractice media. And the malpractice media is writing about it. Is this one of those, you know, automatic releases? Is this one of those purposely released information? Then why don't you just tell us, instead of having all the subterfuge, all the classified war game? Because now the Clinton News Network told China and Russia that that's going on, if it's supposed to be classified. Wouldn't that warrant some kind of investigation? Wouldn't that warrant some kind of reaction on the level? Because that's as treasonous as it comes, isn't it not? Isn't it more treasonous than a supposed insurrection on 1-6? We got information on that as well. But you see the inherent problem here, ladies and gentlemen. Just us is fine again. It's always just us for them. They can leak classified. These are probably the same type of people that are in cahoots with the people that were at the ABC agency James Comey was running when they were doing illegal operations on Americans, or an American, but multiple Americans were being surveilled for no reason. They just claimed they had some kind of connection to one of our adversaries. Well, obviously, these people who are leaking classified information to the Clinton News Network, the malpractice media, and the malpractice media is out there making articles on it. Because, you know, once CNN starts talking about it, other outlets are going to pick up on that. So what was supposed to be classified so that the Russians and the Chinese don't get wind of, now, through the malpractice media, they're going to get wind of it. I got wind of it. If I got wind of it, old 31 in Russia over there, they're going to get wind of it themselves. So where's the reaction out of our justice community, the ABC agency, Federal Bureau of whatever they are, because it's not about investigation? Federal Bureau of Insurrection. That's what we should call them. The Federal Bureau of Insurrection. Because you don't think they had something to do with that 1-6? Okay. Remember, they had connections. They actually had an informant who was the leader of one of the little groups that were down there. Nobody wants to talk about that. You can't be one of those not-so-proud boys and be a informant for the Federal Bureau of Insurrection and expect people like me not to question what happened that day. Especially with the videos that we talked about in the last episode. Clearly letting people in with those sea police. Come on down. You're the next contestant on Get Yourself Entrapped. But nothing's going to happen to any of these leakers. Clearly. CNN is saying several defense officials tell CNN that the war game is a top priority for the chairman of Joint Chiefs of Staff. And it is, according to them, classified. Well, somebody broke the law. Several officials broke the law. Now, how many people knew about this classified war game thing going on? I'm sure we can find out who did the leaking. There's been so many leaks. Orange Man had leaks. Now Joe Petto has leaks. President Zero had leaks. Literally, during President Zero, were the only real good leaks that were of any substance to protect the American people. Or have we forgotten those guys that released all that information? You know, the WikiLeaks guy and the other guy that went and hid out in Russia. You know who those guys are, right? Right. But, you know, whatever. Let's get into the next story. Because it is related. You know, we kind of join topics here. Insurrection fundraiser. Capitol riot extremists. Okay, you get that? They're all extremists because they were led into the building. Trump supporters continue to raise money for lawyer bills online. That's a bad thing. But yes, they're going to do that. Because many of us, and I haven't donated to any of this, but many of us have seen that it was a giant setup. And the people who were innocently sheepled in because they were just stupid, they don't deserve to get in all kinds of trouble. They probably deserve to, like, not vote anymore. But I don't think they should go to jail. They were let in. And just like the cattle, they just followed. Let's go along. Go along. Oh, we can go in that building. We can go in that building. They don't let you in any other time. Do you get that, folks? They don't let you in any other time. There's only certain places that you can go in that building that's available to the public. And the rest of the... But that day, like, free for all, go wherever you want. Then you had Buffalo Head Man just sitting there in the chamber. In the honored chamber. The sacred room. We just got a lot of dummies in this country. But basically, the media, again, this is USA Today, another fine outlet, is upset that people are sending in money. They're calling you extremists for doing that, by the way. Or you're supporting extremism. They don't... Never does the malpractice media ever support extremism. When all those cities were burning down, they were very harsh on those people. Mm-hmm. They would be filming right in front of a burning building and going, nothing happening here. Everything peaceful. Mm-hmm. Peaceful protest here. Oh, don't mind that fire. Uh-oh. Nope. That's a random event. It was coinkydinks. Uh-huh. That was all it was, coinkydinks. So yeah, two stories into the show. We're almost done with the segment here. And I'm, as you can see, not so fired up as I was yesterday. Because it's a little bit disgusting where we're sitting. And reporting this stuff when I know we're just filled with a bunch of people that aren't going to change, aren't going to do anything else to fix the issue. So who cares? Who cares if military secrets, classified information is leaked through the right channels, right? That's okay. If Snowden does it... Or WikiLeaks does it. Just Julian Assange does it. That's bad. But if it goes through the proper channels, that's fine. That's not treasonous, you know? But being led into a... See how everything's backwards? By being led into a building and told to go wherever you want. Go ahead. That's an insurrection. And you're an extremist for doing that. Now, I'm not condoning any of that, again, because those people were not too bright. If you'd ever been down to the 4-3, that's D.C. for you and people in Ecorse, Michigan. If you ever been down to the 4-3, you know there's parts of the Capitol you can't go. Not this day. Nope. You thought that was all right because they told you, go ahead. We're setting you up. Yeah, go ahead. Yeah. Good job, little sheeple. Good job. Hey, Uncle Shady, where are they going?
Hey, you, get back here. The John LeBake Show will be right back.
Are you in need of commercial or residential window cleaning? Do you need your office clean? Maybe custodial work. How about some gutter cleaning? If you do, then call Pain in the Glass. For a beautiful shine that's crystal clear, call Pain in the Glass. You can find them on Facebook at Pain in the Glass.
You're listening to the John LeBake Show.
It's better than an iRater convention.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, now look at what's happening. Apparently, according to The Hill, President Joe Petto plan for re-election freezes Democratic field. Why are they already talking about re-election 2 months into his administration that hasn't done diddly squat outside of put our country in more debt? Do you think anybody cares about the next? We're sick of these ballot box events, actually. And here the malpractice media again brings up the next one. That's who cares? Who cares? Why is Joe Petto even talking about it? And he comes out and basically says that he's probably going to run for 13 again. Hang on a minute. We don't care right now. You're 2 months in. Talk to us in like 2 years. Okay, Joe Petto, if you're still 13 in 2 years, I don't think you're going to be. Because in the same article, they're already setting up that. Deep throat will want to run. And she'll want to carry on the agenda. Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. Again, the point is, you're 2 months in, buddy. Why don't we focus on making this country okay? Because right now, you ain't doing so well. And unless you come up with another Operation Ballot Box, which isn't that far out of the question, then you ain't going to be there for a second term. Because the American people are already 2 months in, sick of it. Took you 2 months to do a press conference at which you bombed at. You're doing things that you don't want to say a majority because people will get upset with you. But a great deal of Americans don't like in the least. So I wouldn't worry about your next election, Joe. Just saying. I'd worry about straightening things out right now. But, you know, it ain't going to happen that way. Because Joe ain't going to run again. That's a smokescreen, ladies and gentlemen. It's a smokescreen. Because people are already catching on that he ain't going to be around. If they didn't know it before, they know it now. The slip and multiple slips and fall going on Air Force One. 2 months to get a press conference, and there are times where he was, well, dementia stricken. Couldn't stay focused. Mm-hmm. But yeah, we're supposed to believe that the next time around, there's a ballot box competition that Joe Petto's going to be there. He's not going to be there in about 3 or 4 months. No later than September, I'm telling you, folks. Be ready. Could be in April. There's going to be a lot of fooling around going on in April, I'm telling you, folks. And you better keep that eye out.
Let's check out some other news. Oakland mayor announces program to give $500 per month to low-income families, but not if you're a pale face. Did you know that, folks? Isn't that discrimination? Government discrimination. Now, if anybody knows the Constitution, you can't do that. But they're going to say, well, there's been discrimination all the other way, and it's just making up for it. No, you don't fix discrimination by imposing other discrimination. Just like you don't stop racism by pushing racism. Mm-hmm. Of course, most people don't get that simple idea. Most people don't understand that common sense. And that's because the ones that are oppressed always want to take down the ones that oppress them. Or the, who they deem oppress them. And here in the greatest country in the world, they've convinced a good amount of people that pale-faced male in particular is a bad thing. Speaking of the male and the female, I got a couple messages after the last broadcast. It was actually about the Daily Brew. I made a comment because it was talking about how there's on the Daily Brew, if you're not familiar, ladies and gentlemen, it's our little glomerfree of articles that we put together, mostly for show prep, but we make it available to you so you can see what the links and all that and read the stories you'd like. And one of the stories in the last Daily Brew was talking about how sex is on the decline last couple years or whatever, and I made a little comment because, you know, I like to be snarky, that I was going to blame the less sex thing on the women because men are blamed for everything else, right? Well, a couple of the listeners actually sent messages thinking I was actually serious about that, and I'm not. I was just having a little fun with it. Sex is on the decline because, well, they give us other outlets, and do you really want to get involved with, you know, other people these days because of, you know, the way they are? We had the story a few weeks ago that we talked about, or maybe that was a week ago. I don't remember anymore. We do so many shows now, 3 a week, with how difficult, especially as an older person, well, with all the difficulties surrounding each person and the baggage that comes, sometimes it's just not worth it to even engage with people, let alone get to the sex part. So, ladies, I was just having a little fun. I was just joshing. I wasn't being totally serious. I mean, there is a point of view I have, but I wasn't being totally serious. I was just joshing because it was an opportunity for me to take a quick little jab. In other news, as we get off the subject of Joe Petto, looks like maybe movies are coming back because, and it took Godzilla, of course. Took Godzilla to get things going again, but Godzilla vs. Kong sets global pandemic record. Had like $131 million it made in its first weekend. Not too bad, considering what conditions they've put us in with the lockdowns, and you can't go here and you can't go there, and the movie thing. And so it was very positive for the movie industry, especially for the theaters and stuff. Now, it took Godzilla, right? Godzilla and Kong, because that's the Godzilla vs. Kong is the movie. But it took Godzilla and Kong, and I don't want to release any spoilers, but there's other kaiju in this movie. I haven't seen it yet. I wanted to see it last Wednesday. I never got around to it. But I'll probably see it just because I'm a huge Godzilla fan. I watched it when I was growing up, and in fact, I mean, that's part of the reason why I liked Asian women my whole life, is because of the fact I watched Godzilla and all the women in those movies, you know, because it's from Japan.
if you didn't know. I mean, Godzilla is probably, that was the first cinematic universe, if you ask me. Way before Marvel and the Justice, whatever, the DC universe, whatever they call it, or the Harry Potter, or any of that. Godzilla had his own cinematic, I don't know how many movies he has, but it is up there with James Bond. As far as how many movies. And James Bond is another one that has a kind of a cinematic universe to it. Unlike, and I don't know how those connect, because I was never a huge Bond fan. I watched it. It was great. But I never paid attention to if they linked the movies together. Some of Godzilla era did. Sometimes they rebooted. With the amount of movies, and it's well over 20, going on 30, I think, maybe even 40. I don't even know. They've been going since the early 60s? So it would take Godzilla and King Kong, who was the big bad monster or kaiju in the United States. It would take those two to reignite the movie theaters a little bit, which is pretty cool. And I don't know if you've watched it or seen it, or if even Godzilla even interests you, because it probably doesn't interest a whole lot of people. But the fact that the movie industry is coming back makes it a positive sign that maybe the boogie woogie virus is on the decline for real. In other words, all the effects of it, because most of us here didn't really feel too afraid of the boogie-woogie virus. Let's move over to the sludge report while we have just a few minutes left. Dominion doesn't rule out suing the Orange Man, because they're suing everybody. And why not? Nobody wanted to hear the case against them. So none of that evidence was ever provided, and it probably won't be able to be provided, because it won't be in specific. They're probably making it so it won't be, that kind of evidence won't be admissible in court for whatever reason. Let's see what else we have on the sludge report. Historic deadly flooding grips Nashville, because they've had a lot of problems down there. Talking about the Boulder, Colorado gunman again. We discussed that in the last episode. What else do we have? There was a couple other news items I wanted to talk about. Dems could undo Trump policies faster, but they're not. They've only undone the ones that they didn't like. There was a lot of Trump policies. Ladies and gentlemen, I know you Orange Men fans really don't see this, but some of Orange Man's policies were beneficial to the Hippocrats and made it a little easier for them to do their thing. So, yeah. Then there's a article saying, can AI replace human therapists? I doubt it. How are you going to get empathy out of a machine? But you never know. And I love this. Right here, they're telling you, I saved this one on purpose. An alliance of autocrats. China wants to lead a new world order. Wow. See how they're preparing you, folks? It isn't the U.S. leading the New World Order anymore. Which means freedom will not be part of the New World Order. Isn't that interesting? What kind of government does China have, and they're going to lead the New World Order? Get the reason why the restrictions are in place? Do you understand why the lockdowns happen now?
T-minus 10.
Do you understand how Operation Battle Box was successful? Because the New World Order.
One. We have liftoff. Tune in again next week. Same time, same space, same station.